To help us make sense of today's market movements, we're now joined by Charmaine Ko of COL Financial. Good afternoon, Charmaine. Welcome to Market Edge.
Good afternoon, Stanley. Thank you for having me.
It's good to have you here. Now let's take a look at today's numbers first. We are ending at 68.42, down 0.16%. And all counters are also down, led by industrials. Given this, what are the next support and resistance levels if, of course, prices are to hover along the 68 to 6900 range and staying below 7000 still?
Yes, that's right. The index closed down today following the weak performance of U.S. markets last night as investors digested the hawkish comments from the Fed officials. We're currently seeing support at 6,700 and resistance at the 7,000 level. Fundamentally speaking, however, we think that the narratives are still intact. The valuations of Philippine stocks are still attractive, with the PSEI currently trading at 14 times earnings. Note that this is lower than its 10-year historical average of 16 times. We see weakness now in share prices as an opportunity to buy, given that at the index current levels, there's still a significant upside of about 16 to 17% to our year-end target of 8,100 for the whole index.
Okay,
Go ahead, please. Oh, sorry. We're optimistic, actually, that the PSEI can hit this target, seeing as the Philippine 10-year bond yields have fallen from their November highs of 7.7%. Furthermore, interest hikes are also expected to slow down in 2023, especially compared to the aggressive monetary policy tightening in 2022.
Okay, still on the subject, of course, of monetary tightening, aside from watching out what the next steps of the Fed will be, we're also on the lookout for our own BSP hiking rates. Now, how do you foresee trading in the next couple of days or up until the release of the BSP decision on policy rates by middle of next week?
Well, we expect the market to trade sideways until the Monetary Board's next policy meeting on February 16, which is, as you said, next week. With the January inflation numbers coming out higher than expected at around 8.7% versus consensus estimates of 7.6, we think that there's a higher possibility that the BSP will actually hike rates by 50 basis points instead of the initially expected 25 basis points.
All right, Charmaine, it's been 2 days, or in fact 3 days, since the shocker of inflation numbers last Tuesday. But a lot of people are still talking about it. Talk about foreign buying now, if this is in fact affecting inflows. Have they been reacting to last Tuesday's consumer print?
Yeah, certainly they have been reacting. We think that the foreigners have actually reacted negatively to the higher than expected inflation in January. And this has led to us seeing some foreign selling today on the market. Furthermore, we think that they're likely taking profit as well, since the index is up 4% year to date.
All right. Now, in the previous months of trading, the consumer and services sectors, particularly the stocks under these sectors, have shown resilience and, of course, good performance on bad years like the past 2 years. They seem to be the go-to issues for investors. Do you still expect significant price appreciation if many of these issues have been bought many times over already?
Well, we actually think that the rally of consumer stocks may be a little bit overstretched as of the moment. That's why we're looking at value plays that have a near-term catalyst, such as the banking sector. As we previously talked about, we do see the possibility of a 50 basis point rate hike from the BSP this month. And this should be beneficial for the banking sector, as net interest margins could improve on the back of loan repricing. At the same time, the funding costs of our banks remain steady, given substantial low-cost deposits, as well as the liquidity that's still present in the system.
All right. Lastly, Charmaine, at COL Financial, you provide your clients with a technical guide which contains buy signals. Now, can you pick a stock or two, perhaps, which are technically are an attractive price position, and what price action do you expect from these stocks? Maybe even an upside.
Okay, so from COL, two stocks that are currently on our radar are MEG and RLC. This is following them being removed from the PSEI last Monday. Mm-hmm. For both of these stocks, we did see some strong price action since their removal, and we think that these stocks have already bottomed out, or if not, are in the process of doing so. They're both trading above their 50-day EMAs and on their way to attempt breakout above the longer day moving averages. Aside from that, fundamentally speaking, of course, we think that both of these stocks are highly undervalued. They're trading significantly below their net asset values. They also have buyback programs which continue to provide support at the current levels.
All right. On that note, we thank you so much for your market guidance, Charmaine Ko of COL Financial. Good afternoon to you and have a good day.
Thank you.